Good morning, how's everyone doing? Today is a special day in the church. It's called Gaudete. Who can tell me what Gaudete means? Anyone? Owen's gonna take a swing here. Let's see if he strikes out. You heard God, Gaudete. You do hear God in there. And you heard in our lesson today a word that's written on our pyramid behind you. Hint, hint. Rejoice. It's the Sunday of joy. Here in the midst of Advent, we are joyful because of what Jesus has done for us. You know what the text from the Old Testament says? That the desert shall blossom. Or the desert shall rejoice and blossom like the crocus. Why is the desert blossoming? Wait a minute. What's in the desert?
Cactus.
Sometimes cactus. The desert that I saw all over the Middle East, there was nothing except sand. We called it the big ashtray. That's what it looked like. Oh, none of you know what an ashtray is, do you? But in the desert, there's no plant life whatsoever. But we hear today that the desert shall rejoice and blossom like the crocus. Well, that crocus reminds us of a flower, doesn't it? And that's why we light the rose, hint, hint, the rose candle. So Silas, if you would do me a favor, we had this planned. We'll see if it works. So far, so good. Here we go. So we light the rose candle on Advent 3. This is not a pink candle. It's a rose candle. And when you guys start dating your girlfriends, you'll want to give them roses, right? Okay. Or you girls will be so in love with your boyfriends that when they give you roses, you'll be overjoyed, just like Ella is right now. Yeah, those days will come. Don't worry. Give it 10 more years. I'll remember well. But this is rose for a purpose. It reminds us of the great joy that we have. The great joy that giving the flower rose brings to the husband and brings to the wife, brings to the bridegroom and the bride. The bridegroom is Jesus and the bride is all of us, the church. But in the desert, there's even a greater gift that blossoms. So Silas, I'm going to give you the candle back. Well, try not to drip any wax on Caden. Lucky you. There's a greater gift that comes to the desert. The desert is a place of barrenness, a place of sin. But there's a great rose that blossoms in the desert, and his name is Jesus. Do you know that Jesus was born as a baby, just like all of you? Because most of you, I remember very well when you were a baby. I remember very, very well. Jesus came to take on flesh, to be a human just like you and me. And in his birth, the desert rejoices because the crocus has blossomed. The rose has come. There is great joy. And why is there great joy in Jesus? What has he come to do for you? Very, very good, Kellen. Kellen's been listening. Kellen's been hearing. And he has spoken the truth by the power of the Spirit. Thank you, Kellen. Thank you, O Lord. Jesus has come to take away all of our sins. And therefore, on this Sunday, we rejoice. You're going to hear that word a lot. You're going to hear the word rejoice. And during our CWS, what's the word that I have here on the pulpit? Remember that word? Ella, joy. I didn't hear you.
Joy.
Yeah, we're to be joyful all the time because Jesus has come into our world and he has gone to the cross and he has died for us. But he didn't stay on the cross, did he? He went into the tomb. But wait a minute. The tomb is empty. He rose on the third day and he ascended into heaven and he has made one final promise that he's going to come and take us into his kingdom. A kingdom that is full of, what's the word?
Joy.
I don't think they heard you.
Joy.
A kingdom of great joy. God's grace to you all. Let's close our eyes and fold our hands and bow our heads and let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for coming into this deserted world, a world of sin and of strife and of suffering. But in you, O Lord, you took all of that, and you have taken them, all of our sins, and all of that strife, and all of that worry to the cross, and you have died for us. And O Lord Jesus, you are the great rose of Sharon, the great rose who has come to give us great joy. Lord Jesus, we give you thanks for all that you have done for us, for all that you are doing right now, and for all that you will do. Even so, Lord, we pray that you will come quickly for us. Lord Jesus, we pray this in your holy name. And all the children said,
Amen.